Before you waste your time watching this
6.5 minute
video, this is not a step-by-step installation guide. Use Sol's included instructions for how to install the exhaust. This video are my tips and some of the challenges that we faced installing the Sol valved exhaust on the 2.9 liter base, and also my review of the exhaust system. I am very impressed with both the weld quality and the sound that you get out of this exhaust. Of course, it's not quite as loud on a 2.9 liter as it would be on a 3.4 liter, but it still sounds amazing. And there's very minimal drone. Check the video link up here and in the description below for a sound clip both before and after. But I am very unimpressed with just the over-engineering of this exhaust system. It's way too complicated, and Sol did not provide very detailed instructions when it came to the wiring and the vacuum line routing. Page 5 literally says, locate a constant engine vacuum source. And then if you go over to page 8, it just says, find a key hot 12 volt power source and tap into it. Those are probably two of the most crucial components to get this exhaust to function properly. And they just say, you know, find whatever works for you and go from there. Okay, but seriously though, like the instructions are so detailed. There's 12 pages in total, I think. And I'd say 10 pages of that is how to bolt on the exhaust, which is basically self-explanatory. Two brackets, 6 bolts that connect to the catalytic converters. You undo those, the exhaust comes off, you bolt on the new one. Only took about an hour to remove the stock exhaust and bolt on the new Sol system. It makes sense that this exhaust system was designed to be a quick plug-and-play upgrade for cars that already had the factory valved exhaust option. But for cars without the factory valved exhaust, it makes absolutely zero sense why you're going to have electronically controlled, vacuum controlled valves. Tapping vacuum lines just creates an additional point for failure, and since we already have to cut and splice wires for the electronic controller, why didn't they just make the valves electronically controlled? That would have been easier, and that would have been a cheaper option to include in the bundle. Also, these universal lock-unlock fobs are just kind of ugly. And I would have expected something of higher quality to be included with an exhaust system that costs nearly $3,000. Though you can program this to the factory home link button, so that's kind of cool, I guess, but still, why this? I'll include a link to Sol's PDF installation guide in the description below because it is useful if you're installing this exhaust on a 3.4 liter S model, but for the base, it's almost completely useless. I understand that they included all these pictures to try to help step you through the process, but these pictures are on an S model, and as you'll notice on page 5, there is no vacuum line directly below the throttle body on a 2.9 liter base. Instead, we had to cut into a line for one of the plenum actuators. Once again, I was faced with another perfect example of Porsche's over-engineering. It would make sense for the vacuum lines that are running to the actuators to be, you know, silicone or rubber vacuum lines, but they're not. What they are a bunch of straight plastic straws, and every time there's a bend or a turn, they have a rubber hose that connects those pieces. Now, one problem with that is that there are like 8 different joints just on this maybe 12-inch long section of vacuum routing, and that doesn't make sense to me why that could have just been a straight hose. It's beyond me. But the bigger problem is that all of those plastic straw pieces, they weren't flared or ridged on the end. They were just slipped into the vacuum lines. Now, I understand on a naturally aspirated car, you're not dealing with high boost pressure that would instantly just blow those lines apart. But still, it was a weak connection. So as we carefully cut the line and are trying to fit on our T-connector for the valved exhaust, well, I accidentally pulled it out of the vacuum hose that it was connected to. And that meant that we had to remove the intake plenum just to reconnect that factory vacuum line. And let me tell you, removing the plenum is, while not necessarily difficult, it's a pain in the butt. For power, I just tapped the 12 volt socket in the passenger footwell, and then I stuck the little module up underneath the dash for unobstructed communication with the little lock unlock fobs. At the end of the day, I mean, at least it sounds great. It functions exactly as it should, exactly as Soul says it should. My biggest complaint is just the fact that Soul says this is an easy bolt-on modification for the 2.9 liter base, and honestly, it really wasn't. This would have taken a total of maybe an hour and a half on an S model, but we spent a good 5 to 6 hours just trying to get the wiring and vacuum hoses routed correctly and dealing with, you know, everything else that came up along the way. But like I said, this is a very great sounding exhaust system. It's well engineered, minimal drone, and it is definitely worth the price that you have to pay. I just wish they included better instructions, and honestly, if I were installing this exhaust on my own car, I would probably just adjust the valves to leave it open all the time because it's not too loud, there's not a bunch of drone, and that would have saved me the hassle of tapping vacuum lines and splicing wires.